Let's get cracking. Which one to start with first?
Let's get this camera in a better spot.
There we go. All right, let's start.
There's up there. I'll get started here.
Cracking open. My old ink jar. This might get messy. So, I've started with a few sketches last night to get ahead, and now I'm going to be inking them up by hand today. I do find inking by hand gives a much better line work than a pen. I can get really thin even with this. Thick brush, what is this? Series 7, number 1. Winsor & Newton Kolinsky. They may be expensive, but they are worth it. They hold so much ink. Let's just spin this around so I don't accidentally. Smudging is the enemy. Boom, boom, boom. This is Miss Jolina LaRouge. Part of my Instagram reboot. Drawing a lot, so I'm going to be drawing all day. I might not be live streaming all day, but this is my first ever live stream, so we'll see how it goes. Always got to wipe away the excess ink off the tip of your brush or you will be in trouble later. Drawing upside down, I know, but it's going with the natural arc of my wrist. Means I can get better lines. Of course, now I'm going to have to go the other way. I'll give it a second just to dry. The worst thing you can do is smudge it right now. That's a jagged line, that one. Nail it here. never remembered. Oh, getting this brush so dirty. Ugh. Really should have a cleaner pot. You lobby. No, didn't wipe it enough, did I? It's all right, nice thick black outline. There we go. Oh, I forgot to sign it. I need to clean this brush because I have gone to the hilt too much. All right, first one down. Need to take a photo and post that one on Instagram. Let everyone know my first sketch is done. There we go. Let's not let that. Try that. 2. This is Miss Tinkerbell. Now, I will be drawing more than just these four gals today. I'm going to be drawing all day. These are just the sketches I did last night. To get a head start so I could just get cracking first thing this morning. And for now, I'm just going to be doing black and white drawings. I may end up coloring these at a later date. Okay. So sometimes I start somewhere else before I go into doing finer details in the face because I want to get a good flow and I want the right amount of ink left on my brush that I do not stuff it up. It's very important not to have too much ink on your brush when you're trying to do fine details because it's easy, very easy to stuff things up. So like that, see, big thick. If I had done that in the middle of the face, it would be all over. You can get away with things in other areas, but not on the face. It's weird drawing with no music. I normally have some music on. Should put some headphones in, but then I don't know. I'm enjoying the quiet. Hello from Denmark. I just see some comments in my section. If anyone wants to ask me anything, feel free. It's 1:30 in the morning there. Wow. It's 9:30 here, so start of a long day for me. I'm going to be drawing here all day. I might not be live streaming all day. That'll have to go on and off throughout the day, but I'll do what I can. remember to breathe sometimes. I get too focused in drawing and then forget to breathe. Holding your breath so your brush doesn't wiggle. I do love inking with a brush. Beats a pen any day of the week. And those who go, oh my God, you're crazy inking with a brush, that is because you have never done it. Or you've never done it with a good brush. Highly recommend these Winsor & Newton Series 7 Kolinsky brushes. They'll cost you like $30 a brush here in Australia. But they are so worth it. They hold so much ink, which means you don't have to dip it constantly and refill, which takes up extra time. And they don't drip. They're just absolutely amazing. Spin this around and get the outside on all. There we go. Right there. Wow, that's a good line, nice thick and thin. Oh, there we go, beautiful. Beautiful. I always like to go thinner around the ankles with my line work. I'm just going to sign it. I always rough out my signature because there's nothing worse than doing your signature and running out of room. plus, then I can make sure it looks nice. Beautiful. Wobbly. There we go. And there's number two down. Brush up. Take a quick snap for Instagram. Hi, Veronica Parker and LED Lee. Oh, you like these? Thank you very much. I'm from Melbourne too, LED. Veronica. Bear with me for a second while I post this to Instagram for the Miss Tinkerbell. All right, let's move these over. This here is Miss Munrose's. Let's get to inking this one, shall we? This is the part where I'm not allowed to breathe. Finest of finest lines. Be very, very quiet. We're hunting rabbits. There we go. Whew. Ooh, big thick line there. Oh well. What you gonna do? Oh, hello, South Carolina, Billy Jane. Amazed how far everyone is spread throughout the world. I am from Australia, Melbourne. Ooh, fingers, another delicate part to draw. Now I should color this in black as it is. Get the pressure when you're drawing not to make any mistakes, especially in ink, because black ink is kind of unforgiving. I've got to do these tattoos. I might release some of the heavier ink there. I'm going to do this upside down because I've got to do it really fine. There's a little ice cream cone here. And bouquet of flowers here. And on this side, we got a key and a heart-shaped locket. There we go. I should probably do... I think I'll save the pattern for when I do color. I won't do black line right there because I'm gonna want it faded black. I'm going to do these in stages, so I'm not going to color anything until I get to that stage. Then I'll color them all at once. Trying to start thin and end up thick. Real thin on those ones. There we go. How's those lines? Cannot see a thing in here. It's just a black void, so it's really hard to see where the ink surface is. I don't want to dip my brush too far in. It'll ruin the brush. And I have never used a ruler in about 20 years of thinking. It's one of the first rules my first mentors and teachers told me is not to use a ruler. Then when you need to draw a nice straight line, you've had the practice. And I always liked it. Curve those lines a little bit anyway. Thick, thin, and let's go a little bit thicker at the end there too. There we go, nearly. Oh, where are we? Come on, let's go. No one makes a comeback quite like Sheardo. Thank you, Hannah Murphy. Yeah, I got to do it right. I don't do things by halves. And I've been gone so long. I got to give everything back. Nearly done, number three. Oh. There we go, number three. Take another photo. Oops. Might move those out of the way for a bit. Give me a second. Oh, don't roll over there. You know what? I've put my brush down before on a drawing to take a photo of it, and then ended up smudging the whole thing because it wasn't dry yet. Oh my god, that was a bad day. All right, let's get back into it. One more to go for this first little set. This is Oh Golly Miss Dolly. Oh golly, it's Miss Dolly. Sorry, my mistake. All right. This one's got a bit of detail. Fishnets. I'm always going to take a bit. Let's get some ink on that brush. Bit of tattoos there. Very fine. Go. Oh, there we go. There's a hang up for you. Gotta breathe there. Thank you, Real Craft, Real Cafe Beauty, and Luna Miles. Thank you very much. Now this earring is gonna be tough. So small. So small. Oh. I think you can see that amount of detail in the feed on my webcam. Well, thank you, everyone, for your comments. Sorry, I just had a quick little glance over at the feed there. It's good to see everyone chatting away. It's hard to focus on my drawing and communication at the same time. It's always drawing like this takes a lot of focus. So I often get headaches after I finish drawing because I've just been thinking so much, you know. Sometimes your breathing gets funny and you think a lot when you're drawing, not, you know, using a different side of your brain, which reminds me I should be taking a big swig of water. Excuse me. And number two done. Yeah, I really love, Mr. Sheard, I'm using the brush. It gives so much variety, and it just looks so nice in the end. You got to be really delicate with the amount of pressure you put on it, but it's really worth it in the end. It takes a little bit to get used to and getting that control, but it's definitely worth it. Normally I should switch to a fatter brush to do the coloring in like this, but I'm a bit lazy at the moment. I might change to a thinner brush to do the fishnet detail because I do want that to be really fine. And I have what have I got here? It's a zero as well. That will just make this drawing sing once the fishnet detail's in. I know it's extra time, but it's going to be worth it. And I got to work my way down this drawing so I don't smudge it. That would be killer. Absolute killer. Breathe. Another one of those moments I just held my breath for a bit too long and forgot to breathe. How do I find it takes a screenshot swap from ink back to working on a tablet or vice versa? Swapping from doing things by hand and by on a tablet. It's different when I'm doing this because I got a brush in my hand, but when I'm doing the sketches, I constantly find myself trying to zoom in on the page. Sometimes I don't literally do it, but sometimes I do, and then I laugh at myself and go, oh, man, you're an idiot. What a goose. But, yeah, you get so used to being able to zoom in to do that extra detail that when you don't have that ability. And I'm getting older, my eyes aren't as, you know, good as they used to be. I got this pair of glasses nowadays. This is a new addition for me. Oh, look, I can zoom in. See? Oh, let's see that detail there. Yeah, new addition while I was in lockdown. Realized I was getting more headaches, and it was because I couldn't see. Thick and thin line. That's why the brush works so good, because you just have to press a tiny bit harder to get it thicker and a bit more delicate to get it thin. And oh, I don't know. And I also find sometimes this line work you cannot beat digitally. This one, how's these shoes? Amazing. Oh, boom, there we go. So I shouldn't really call them shoes. They're boots, aren't they? Ooh, breathe, Mark, breathe. There's the finish done. Not that this drawing's finished. I've got to go in now and dirty ink, clean ink, water, whatever. Ink, water, same thing. Not. All right, let's go to my super fine brush. Just going to blow on this for a bit, make sure that ink is dried properly. I would hate to smudge it. Okay. Last little bit, and then I'll be signing off for the live stream for a bit. Thank you, everyone who's popped by. Okay. go. Spin around, trying to work out what angle I'm going to go from. No, I'm going to go this way because these crisscrosses are going to have to. Coming along. I'm gonna do the legs. Legs are the hard ones. Sorry, Billy Jane, that you've been popping in and out. Been good to have you here. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Trying to make sure the fishnet lines go and follow the contours of the form. That's why it makes it hard. How's that looking? I think I've gotten a bit. All right. on that for a bit. Before I do the crisscrossing, I would hate to smudge it once again. Gotta be careful. Come on, where's that at? There we go. All right. Oh, there's one lid done. You get them right, those fishnets, and it ends up an optical illusion. It's just, it's hard to get right, though. I've stuffed it up so many times. There's a reason why they look so cool. All right, I'm going to have to spin this one. Get any ink on there. Too much up there. Oh, that one was a bit thick. And there we go. Drawing number 4 is done. Well, thank you very much for everyone who popped into the live stream here. It's the first time doing it, so it's very happy. I hope you enjoyed watching a little bit of the behind the scenes. I might be on it a little bit later today. So hopefully you'll join me again then. Until then, I will see you later. I'm still going to be drawing all day, so follow me on Pinups by Sheardo on Instagram, and I will see you all there. Thank you very much. Bye.